Welcome back to all. So this is the 37th lecture on quantum mechanics, and also this is the second part of the about the hydrogen atomic orbital wave function. So in my last lecture I have introduced you about the different hydrogen atomic orbitals. Now in this lecture I will talk about mostly about the nodes that were present in the hydrogen atomic orbitals, as well as the different eigenvalues of the hydrogen atom. Now just I am briefly going through what is that hydrogen model or quantum mechanical hydrogen model. So according to the quantum mechanical hydrogen model system, the positive charge of the nucleus is at the center of the hydrogen atom, and the electron is rotating around in three dimension around this positively charged proton. And you can see this is the distance between the positively charged proton and the electron, that is designated by R. And there were basically two types of angle, that is one angle is called theta, that is the polar angle, which is this angle, the angle between this R and the Z axis, and another angle that is called azimuthal angle, or it is designated as phi. So by knowing these three parameter, that is R, theta and phi, we can actually fix the coordinates of the electron. So this is basically the polar coordinates, that is the polar coordinate representation. So it is always better to represent the hydrogen atom in polar coordinates, because as the potential energy depends on R, so we always prefer to use all the wave function as well as the operator in terms of spherical polar coordinate, that is in terms of R, theta and phi, these three parameters. Now you can see this is the general expression for Hamiltonian operator for hydrogen atom model system. So you can see that this part is the kinetic energy operator, that is minus h cross square by 2 me. Me is the mass of the electron, and delta square, this is called the Laplacian operator. This is called the kinetic energy operator, and this part is called the potential energy operator. This potential energy operator exists because of the attraction between the positively charged electron and the positively charged nucleus and negatively charged electron. So as this attraction is as this interaction is attractive, so that's why there is a negative sign. So this is the total Hamiltonian operator for the hydrogen atom wave function. Now we can use this Schrodinger's equation, that is h psi is equal to e psi, to solve the hydrogen atom model system, and we can derive different parameters using this Schrodinger's equation. So by using this Schrodinger's equation, we can actually determine the energy for any given nth level if we know the exact expression of the Hamiltonian operator as well as the exact expression of the wave function for hydrogen atom. And you can see that this wave function psi, this is the total wave function, it's depend upon the three quantum number, that is n, l, m. So we have already discussed about this three quantum number. N is called the principal quantum number, l is called the angular momentum quantum number, and this m is called the azimuthal quantum number. Now in my previous lecture also I have shown you that the total wave function for the hydrogen atom orbital is basically split into two part. The first part is called the radial component, that is RNL. This radial component is only depending upon this R value and this two quantum number N and L. So this is the radial component, and this part is called the angular component, that is designated by this YLM. So L and M are the two quantum number, and it's depend upon the two parameter or two angle, theta and phi. So we have also told you that this angular component, that is YLM, is exactly same for the wave function in a rigid rotor model system. Now, as you know that node is the region where the electron density becomes zero. So, depending upon the type of nodes in a hydrogen atomic orbital, there are two types of node. The first type is called the radial node. So, from some certain value of the radius away from the proton, the electron density becomes zero, and this node is called basically radial node. And another type of node can be observed, that is called the angular node. So there are at some certain value of theta or phi, at some particular angle, the electron density becomes zero, and these nodes are called the angular node. So you can see by this pictorial representation. So for 1s orbital there is no node, so the electron density exponentially decreases to zero. Now in case of 2s orbital, you can see that in between these two electron dense population there is a region, and this region is called the first node. Now you can see that practically the electron density is not exactly zero, but you can say that the electron density goes through some minimum point in between this point and this point. So in between these two points the electron density goes through to some minimum point and or minimum region, and this region is called the first nodal or radial node for 2s atomic orbital. Now in case of 3s there are two nodes. Now you can see that this is the first dense electron dense region, and then this is the second dense electron dense region, and in between these two region, this region is called the first node. Similar thing occurred in between this electron dense region and this electron dense region, and in between these two region, this region is called the second node. Now you can see that for 1s orbital there is no radial node present, in 2s orbital there is one single radial node, and in case of 3s atomic orbital there are two radial nodes. So as we are going from 1s to 2s to 3s, the radial node is increases by 1. So this is the pictorial representation of the angular node. So you can see that around this angle the electron density of 2pz and 3pz orbital becomes zero. So this node is called the angular node. So in case of 2pz there is only one angular node, and in case of 3pz also there is only a single angular node. Now we will see in this slide that how we can predict about the number of nodes present in some orbital. So this is the empirical formula to calculate the number of radial node as well as angular node present in some orbital. So you can see that the formula, that the number of radial node will be equal to n minus l. It should be l, okay, it is not 1, it is confusing. So n minus l minus 1. So this is the formula for number of radial node. What is n? N is the principal quantum number and l is the angular quantum number. So similarly to the number of angular node is equal to l, only the value of the angular quantum number, and the total number of node will be this one, number of radial node plus l. So if you just add these two, this l and minus l and plus l will be cancelled out, and the remaining, that is n minus 1, is the total number of nodes present in some orbital present in hydrogen atom. So you can see that l is called the orbital angular quantum number. So according to the number of this l value, these orbitals are designated with different types of signature. So for l is equal to, it will be 0. I'm again sorry for this mistake. So for l is equal to 0, the orbital is called the s orbital. For l is equal to 1, the orbital is called p orbital. For l is equal to 2, the orbital is called d orbital. L is equal to 3, the orbital is called f, and for l is equal to 4, the orbital is called g, and so on. You can name this orbital alphabetically. So these are some of the examples of how you could calculate the number of angular node, radial node, and total number of nodes. So this is given in a tabular format. So I am just going to explain few of them. You can easily calculate them. So suppose we take this orbital 3p. Okay, so for 3p orbital, this 3 is the principal quantum number, that is n is equal to 3. And as you can see that for l is equal to 1, the orbital will be p. So for p, this angular quantum number will be equal to 1. So to calculate the angular number of angular node, the formula is the number of angular node is simply this orbital angular quantum number l. So for 3p, l is equal to 1, so the number of angular node will be equal to 1. Okay, and in case of radial node, the number of radial node formula is n minus l minus 1. So you can see for 3, n is equal to 3, l is equal to 1. So the formula that we obtain, n minus 1 l minus 1, that is 3 minus 1 minus 1, that will be equal to again 1. So here the number of angular node is equal to 1 and number of radial node is equal to 1. So the total node will be just, we have to add these two value. So the total node will be equal to 2. So similarly, if we just see the example of 4D. So for 4D, n is equal to 4. For D, the orbital angular quantum number L is equal to 2. So you can see that for angular, number of angular node is equal to simply equal to L. So L is equal to 2. So the number of angular node is equal to 2. And the number of radial node formula is n minus L minus 1, that is 4 minus 2 minus 1, that is equal to 1. So the number of radial node will be equal to 1 for 4D orbital. And the total number of node will be equal to 2 plus 1, that is equal to 3. So similarly, by using this formula, you can easily calculate the number of angular node, number of radial node, and total number of node using this formula. Okay. Now here I am going to talk about the hydrogen atom eigenvalues. So here we will discuss about the hydrogen atom eigenvalues for three different operators for which the hydrogen atom wave function is basically an eigenfunction. So you can see that I have told you that this is the expression of the Hamiltonian operator for hydrogen atom. So this Hamiltonian operator is also called the total energy operator. Okay, so this Hamiltonian operator is basically an eigenfunction for hydrogen atom. So, why it is an eigenfunction of hydrogen atom? So if we just operate this operator H into this hydrogen atom wave function, that is psi, so we will obtain H psi will be equal to some constant value into again that wave function psi. So that constant value is called the total energy of the hydrogen atom system. So that's why this operator basically is an so we can say that the this hydrogen atom wave function is basically an eigenfunction of the Hamiltonian operator. So this is the expression, or this is the wave function of the hydrogen atom orbital, which is basically depending upon the three quantity r, theta and phi, and also it's depend upon this three quantum number n, l and m. And again we have this wave function is also eigenfunction of the two other operator, that is called the L square and LZ operator. Okay. So if the expression of the L square operator, that is square of the total orbital angular momentum operator, the expression of this operator in spherical polar coordinate is like this, and the expression of this Z component of the angular momentum orbital angular momentum operator is like this. Okay, so this is the total orbital angular momentum operator, and this is the Z component of the total orbital angular momentum operator. So as this wave function is basically an eigenfunction of this operator, so if this operator L square is operating on the hydrogen atom wave function, we will obtain some constant value into this hydrogen atom wave function. So this constant value, that is H cross square into L plus 1, this is the total angular momentum which is squared. So if you just take the square root of this value, that is will be equal to H cross into root over of L into L plus 1, that will be the total angular momentum of the hydrogen atom orbital. Okay. So you can see that this psi is basically depending upon the three quantum number, that is called the n, l and m. So how to determine this value? So for n, this a for n value is always an integer value which has always value greater than or equal to 1. So n can be 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. So for any value of n, the value of l will be equal to this one. So like if the value of n is equal to 3, l can have any value like 2, 1, 0. Okay, n cannot be greater than this 3 value. Okay, and for any value of l, like any, suppose that the value of l is +3, m can vary in between +3 to -3. So this is the formula to determine the all these quantum numbers. And the eigenvalue of Hamiltonian operator is the total energy of the wave function. Okay, so those things you have to consider. So as I have already told you that this Lz operator, that is the z component of the total orbital angular momentum operator. So as this wave function is also an eigenfunction of this operator, so if we operate this operator upon this hydrogen atom wave function, we will obtain some constant value, that is the eigen value, into this wave function again. So this constant value, that is called the mh cross. Okay, so this constant value is called the z component of the orbital angular momentum. Okay, so you have to remember that there is not a single wave function that is possible which would have same eigenvalue for all three different operator, which means that for two wave function, the three quantity, that is energy, eigenvalue of L square and the eigenvalue of Lz operator, cannot be same. Okay, so this is basically a type of Pauli's exclusion principle. Now you can see this is the diagram that I have already previously discussed, this diagram. So in the y axis, this is en versus the mod value of e1, and you can see that for n is equal to 1, that is for principal quantum number n is equal to 1, only we will obtain m is equal to 0 and l is equal to 0. So that's why there is only single energy state. Similarly, for n is equal to 2, okay, for n is equal to 2, l can be only 0 and 1. Okay, so for n is equal to 2, l can be 0 and 1. For l is equal to 0, m can have only one value 0, and again for l is equal to 1, l can have this value 1, 0 and -1. So that's why for n is equal to 2, there are 4 degenerate energy levels. So they are degenerate with respect to the total energy. Okay, so for this 4 systems or the 4 energy states, they have the same energy. Okay, however the other two quantity, that is the eigenvalue of L square and eigenvalue of the Lz operator, are not same. So these two eigenvalue distinct this energy states. Okay, similarly for n is equal to 3, L can have 2 value, that is L can have 0 plus 1 is 0, 1 and 2. Similarly for L is equal to 0, m can have value 0. L is equal to 1, m can have -1, 0, +1, it would be +1. And for L is equal to 2, m can have value from +2 to -2. So by combining this, all these things, we can see that for n is equal to 3, there can be total 9 degenerate energy levels. So all these energy levels are degenerate, but they are different in terms of the eigenvalue of the L square and Lz operator. So all these three, all these 9 states, they do not have all this 9 state do not have the same eigenvalue for the three operator, like Hamiltonian operator, Lz operator and L square operator. Their eigenvalues are not same for any of these three of these 9 energy states. Okay, so similarly for n is equal to 4, there are total 16 degenerate energy levels. So you can see that each psi nlm they have the set of NLM value. So you can see that for this state it has psi n value is equal to 2, l value is equal to 1 and m value is equal to plus 1. But this state, this has separate psi NLM value, that is it has n value is equal to 2, l value is equal to 1 and m value is equal to minus 1. So all these states all have separate set of psi NLM value which differentiate these energy states, although they have same energy. So you can see that in overall there are three types of eigenvalue that we have discussed. The first eigenvalue is the if we operate this Hamiltonian operator upon this hydrogen atom wave function, we will obtain the eigenvalue which is known as the energy. So this is the total energy of any nth state. So if we operate this Hamiltonian operator on the hydrogen atom wave function, we will obtain the total energy. Similarly, if we operate this operator L square on hydrogen atom wave function, we will obtain the eigenvalue which is basically the square of the total angular momentum operator. So if we take the square root of this value, we will obtain the total angular momentum operator. Similarly, if we operate this operator LZ operator upon this hydrogen atom wave function, we will obtain the Z component of the orbital angular momentum for any hydrogen atom wave function. So you can see that this is only possible because this wave function psi is basically an eigenfunction of these three operators. So that's why we will get these three distinct eigenvalues, and all this for single hydrogen atom. For a single hydrogen atom, there are no two psi value which has all three eigenvalues same, which is practically not possible for a single hydrogen atom. So that's it from this lecture. In the next lecture, I will talk about the radial distribution wave function. That will be the last part of the hydrogen atom model system. So till then, take care of yourself. Bye.